Let's continue with the silk fibers. Today in this video, we are going to learn about silk processing. So, what is silk processing? So, we can say the process of obtaining silk from the cocoons is called silk processing. What is a cocoon then? It is a covering of silk threads that the larvae of moths and other insects make for themselves before they grow into adults to protect the pupa. And one more thing I would like to remind you is, what is sericulture? So the process of silk production on a large scale is called sericulture. This is also known as silk farming. Now we can start the entire process of silk processing. The entire production process of silk can be divided into several steps. First, raising silkworms and harvesting cocoons. Second, sorting of cocoons. Third is boiling of cocoons. Fourth, reeling of silk thread. Fifth is dyeing and weaving. Now let us discuss these steps in detail. First, that is raising silkworms and harvesting the cocoons. Extracting raw silk starts by cultivating the silkworms. The healthiest moths are selected for breeding. The female moth lays many eggs at a time. The eggs are kept in a hygienic and controlled environment. They are warmed to suitable temperature for larvae to hatch. Once hatched, the larvae are kept in bamboo trays and fed large quantities of mulberry leaves. After 25 to 30 days, racks of twigs are placed in the trays for the worms to attach and spin cocoons. The cocoon stage in the life cycle of silk moth is the desirable stage for the silk producers. Silk is obtained from the undamaged cocoons. Next is sorting of cocoons. The cocoons are sorted according to the color, size, shape, texture, and also they are checked for any defects, as these affect the final quality of the silk. Cocoons may range from white and yellow to grayish in color. After sorting, the cocoons go for the next stage of processing, that is boiling of cocoons. Boiling of cocoons is very essential in the silk processing, as the cocoons are boiled to kill the worm inside. Otherwise, it will damage the cocoons. Second, the cocoons are dipped in boiling water to obtain the silk fibers, as on boiling, the gum sericene that stick the silk filaments together get dissolved and the silk fibers get separated. The silk fibers obtained from the cocoons now undergo some more steps. Next is reeling the filaments. The process of unwinding the silk filaments from the cocoon for use as silk is called reeling the silk. The silk filaments are very fine, so they are combined together to make a thread of raw silk. 3 to 10 strands are usually reeled at a time to produce the desired thickness of reeled silk, which is known as raw silk. Here let me remind you that the damaged or waste cocoons are used to produce an inferior quality of silk called spun silk. So in this process, the cocoons are not wasted at all. And the last is dyeing and weaving. Depending upon the needs, the raw silk, which is packed into bundles, can be dyed in desired colors, which further adds to the beauty of silk. And dyed silk fibers are then woven into silk fabric by the use of weaving machines. So this is all about silk processing. In the next videos, we will study about the properties and health hazards of sericulture.